This is Mathieu from MadMapper, and I'm here with Colas Friesman, who developed a C++ plugin for Touch Designer. So the idea is that with MadMapper and the laser extension, we have a nice tool for laser mapping, but we don't have the generative possibilities that that people used to Touch Designer are used to. And so we decided to make a small bridge, but it's an open source protocol, so anyone is free to use it. It could be easily implemented in processing, in Python or whatever. So the idea actually in Touch Designer is that you can generate some geometry. So here we have a bunch of cycles being generated. You have to pass through a SOP. I'm not an expert in Touch Designer, but it's used to tell which shapes are closed and which are not. So you have to go through this one, and then there is a Ponk. Ponk is the name of the protocol. It stands for passes over network. So this is a Ponk output node, and it is used to send the geometry to someone somewhere, and you have to specify the IP address of the receiver. So actually we send it on the local network loopback. There is a unique ID which allows you to create multiple Ponk outputs to send different streams. So it's a bit like a spout or siphon, but for geometry information. It can transmit geometry, but also along the passes, you can define some colors. So it's not just the geometry, it also contains color information. So actually, we are sending it on the local network interface, and I can switch to MadMapper, where we are actually receiving the Touch Designer is appearing here. This is the name it gives automatically, but it's actually identified by the unique ID. So we could have multiple Touch Designer live input streams, geometry streams from MadMapper. So actually I have a quad here. Well, if I just drag and drop the Touch Designer source, I can see that I have the geometry being rendered. I can also, like with video surfaces, select which part of the geometry I want to show on my quad. Of course, I can do perspective transform, and I can do mesh warping transform. And this is all working like with video surfaces. Okay. Hop. And thanks to it, and also, yeah, since we are in MadMapper, so we have all those tools of selecting the input, moving with perspective, doing mesh warping, but also masking some areas where we don't want to render, or at the opposite, we might want to invert mask and say, okay, this is a place where I want to render something. So we can do it, for instance, with a rectangle. And then we say to MadMapper, just render inside this area, which is quite useful when you want to project on the stage, but there are some people in some places, so you don't want to shoot with lasers to people's eyes. Or some other situations exist. So actually we made a small project here where we use laser dispatching. So actually this is the source coming from Touch Designer that we are putting in a laser projector where we activated the internal loopback and saying we want to dispatch to three outputs. And then this is a feature of MadMapper. There is a YouTube tutorial about it. And it allows you to dispatch many shapes, because at some point when where there is too much content to be rendered, the laser scan is too slow and it starts to blink. So ideally, we can see here the laser projector info. Oops, we can see that here. If I was drawing directly that on a laser projector, I would have 15 FPS, between 10 and 20 FPS, generally, depending on the size of the content to be rendered. And we start to see the blinking really under 45 FPS, generally. And so it's actually, it will be blinking a lot. So what we do is we say, we want to dispatch this to three outputs, and it will create three medias, each containing a part of the projector outputs. So it's a loopback, but with multiple medias being generated. People who are used to MadMapper can understand this. And then I will create, after that, three quads. With mesh warping, because I want to adjust them so they show the same thing. So it's blinking a lot here because the camera is not that good. It's blinking much less with the eyes. I can show a bit the process of dispatching. So if I take this surface and I put a grid on it, then I can see the grid here. So actually the grid is blinking because it's rendered at 11 FPS, but anyway, I can put the grid on my other laser projector here, and by adjusting the mesh warping, I can really align both grids together, like this. Okay. Oops. Okay. Then I've got a third laser projector where I also align the grid so they almost match correctly. And then, if I put the dispatched content one part on each of those quad surfaces with mesh warping, then they will perfectly match. I could put something else here. For instance, if I use the laser text surface, yeah, it's burning the image. And then you can see that it's dispatching correctly all the content. Oops. Okay. So that's a new protocol, which is called Ponk, and we're happy to show it. And it's an open source project, so if I can try to show, it's on GitHub, Ponk. Ah, sorry, GitHub, Ponk. Okay, I'm on. Yeah, okay, I won't show it to you right now, but it's an open source project. Everyone is free to implement it, and there are C sample code, and there is a touch designer plugin source code and sample projects. So it's supported in MadMapper since version 5.16, and you're free to use it as much as you want. Enjoy. Bye.